Well, that's our top eight. Mia Cramble will be out onto the mats, first of all. Vita Lukin, Ryu Nakagawa, Natsuki Tani, Laura Rogera, Yanya Garbrett, Hannah Moyle, Chen So finishes things up.
Maybe one of them is better for heel hooks, stays on her foot better, and she sees a lot of heel hooks on that foot. But those shoes are fairly similar.
We'll have to see.
Yeah, I'm not sure. It could also just be that maybe she likes the Dragos, the one on her right foot, better, but the left one broke earlier or something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, sure.
I'm not sure.
Or maybe an injury or something, or like a bunion.
Yes, and so that one's like slightly bigger, yeah.
Yeah. So the beginning of this women's route is pretty straightforward. There is a jump coming up here, though. That's quite a long way on the screen. Oh, just gets it. That right hand looked like it was peeling off for a sec.
Yeah. For a second, I thought she was just going to try to go one-handed.
Yeah. And then she's safely through. Then gets a high foot, swaps the feet. There's not much of a nubbin down there, but it's something to stand on. Then gets the heels in. So the women's route is a bit more direct than the men's is. Still got a twist in the middle, a snake from right to left. That's one of the heel hooks, perhaps. That's why she chose those shoes. Obviously our leaderboard clear at the moment because she's the first athlete out. Such a shame we didn't get to see any men on the top of that wall, but hopefully the women will show us what could have been. Into the pockets now. Do athletes have a choice finger when you're putting your fingers in these pockets? Like back two or front two? Is that something that happens? So when you're climbing, for example, do you choose the same fingers or does it depend on the hold?
Depends on the hold. I'm not amazing at pockets, but I'll often try both of them and see what just feels better in the moment. Because I know there's been times where I like either, ooh, I like this press right in the middle. That's cool.
Yeah. Looks a bit awkward though, blind on the feet.
Yeah, a clip hitting you in the shoulder.
Yeah, reminding you it's there.
Yeah. What do you like, back two or front two?
I am a solid front two person.
Okay,
my back two are weak.
That's interesting because most people have, say, because they share the same tendon, they're stronger.
Yeah. So Mia now on the crimps. Approaching the head wall, she's done really well. Oh, big bump up to the right hand crimp. And then more pockets to come.
Oof. Yeah, very pockety route.
Yeah, very similar kind of sequence to the lower pockets. Three fingers in these, stacking them a little bit.
Crossing, yeah. Ooh. Around the rope there, a little bit awkward.
Yeah,
it looks different up here. It looks like a very old school route. The holds are so small rather than big holds on volumes.
I quite like it. The lover of dirty crimps.
Throwback.
Yeah. So now she's about to enter what would have been the shared part of this route. And as I'm saying this, I'm looking at the spotlights and rain is starting to fall again. Okay, out to the first crimp, bumps to the left.
All right, and our first look at the head wall.
Yeah, this is it. So this is where the men would have joined it as well. The audience are enjoying the first look at this. Quick climbing from here as well. She's got 2 minutes 23 on the head walk. Awkward match with the feet. Crosses onto the slope. Is there. Oh.
Very slopey looking.
Yeah, and these are, I said there weren't many tick marks, but these are tick marked. Oh, but they are slopey, aren't they? She nailed the first one, slips on the second one. She's had a good season. Consistently in the top 20. 14th in Edinburgh, 10th in Copper.
Just missing finals, though, almost every single time, unfortunately.
Yeah. So it's good to see her back here. She's had a few unlucky instances in semi-finals.
Yes. That's right.
They'd be right on the cusp. I'd put that frustration on the back burner. Keep on training, keep pushing. And here comes the first dodgy moment, the jump. Right hand, left hand. It's more awkward than it looks like. A bit around the corner, that left hand, and you get to it second.
Yeah.
bumps up to the slopers. And this is where the slippery conditions out here start to get to you a bit. You've got to grip a little harder. I'm not sure if there is a jib on that one.
No, it didn't look like it.
Saw a few men peeling off the top of the semi-final route because of that slippiness.
Yes. And even Vita, her foot slipped.
It's funny how a hole can be that big and yet still be hard to hold. You know, it's if you're not a climber, it seems a bit obtuse, but it makes sense because it's hard to hold and it's overhanging. So the first of the pockets on this old school route, as we're deciding to call it. That crimp's really horrible when she's standing on because it's right by the metal coping, and if you put a foot on the slippy bit, it's not the best of ideas.
Yeah. Be really precise with your toe there.
So bumping that left hand up, campus style.
Yeah, she's very extended here.
Yeah, she's stretched out. Oh,
nice.
That's a very Vita Lukin-esque move, that. Remember the press. I mean, oh, now it comes, but there's a different way of getting into it for Vita.
Oh, almost the same.
Very similar. And that press, I mean, how it looks painful with the shoulder. Is it as painful as it looks, or is it quite restful?
No, it's quite restful because she's not using any muscle here, if that makes sense. Like, she's just pressing, like, her arm's completely straight and locked out. So it's actually quite a comfortable position once you're in it. Sometimes getting into them and getting out of them can be a little finicky. Definitely balancey to get out of them, usually, especially because you can see she's on fairly small crimps. No problem for her.
Yeah, good use of drop knees throughout.
Yeah, Vita's quite good at drop knees. You'll see her do those crazy over drop knees where her knee is actually twisted and pointing towards the ground quite often.
Right, so she, same way as Mia, drops back down to re-chalk up. I guess that pocket isn't quite as good as it looks on camera, maybe. And you've got to commit because the second you start moving off it, you're fully into it. Double bump into the crimp, and she's going to get towards the head wall as well now. Feet almost in the men's route on the left. So she's framed by the spotlights, followed her all the way up the wall.
Let's see what she can do with all these slopers up here.
Right, locks off the crimp now. Feet sliding.
Yeah. Oh, this looks awkward.
Oh, I thought she was gone there.
Yes, for sure I thought she was gone.
Right hand. This is where Mia went. So she's got shoe protectors on. That's what she's sliding off there. A bit like what you'd take into a very posh house if you didn't want to scrape the floor. I'm sure there's a better way of describing that. It's the only one that popped into my head.
It's basically like if you put a pair of socks over your shoes.
Yes, that's better. Right, so easy through this bit. Just be careful with the feet. The warm-up wall for the athletes is in the isolation area, which is way to the left of the stadium.
Yeah, it's maybe 100 meters away. Yeah.
And air conditioning there, so it's a bit cooler.
Lovely, yeah.
And there was a paddling pool that no one seemed to be using. Did you see anyone in the paddling pool?
It was not a paddling pool, we asked. It was a storage facility for the ice.
Oh, fine. I thought it was a paddling pool.
Yeah, my coach pointed out that if we all went in the paddling pool, it would be disgusting.
True.
We're very sweaty here. It's very warm. Oh, wow. She's crimping the metal part of protector on that part of the wall.
I've never seen anyone do that.
No. Granted, this wall has been used for just two World Cups.
True. But holding on to that, I've seen people stand. I can't remember what it was. It was coping along, I think it was Innsbruck. You know where the head wall meets the overhang?
Yes.
I've seen people stand on that, but never crimp it. Right, up she goes into the slopey dish. The clock, by the way, we're working on that. We'll let you know if it becomes an issue, but time certainly hasn't been a factor so far for anyone. But we're trying to get it sorted for you. So left heel up on the dish. We have a slow burn of this women's final. We know where it's going to get hard, and it's just kind of, it's efficiency at this point, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, and it's a little bit different. It doesn't seem unlike the men's route, it seemed like there were places that people were doing things differently. There's not so much of that. This is the third climber, but...
Yeah, of course. But yeah, it's easier to read, I think, from the men's one.
Yes. Yeah.
Nothing too tricky. Right, so she gets the clip in, though. Into the pockets with the left, leaning back on that arm in order to rest, using your back muscles as well as the arms. She's resting her way up through this nicely. Taking her time. Drops back down, checks the clock. You wonder if those pit pockets would get more greasy or whether they'd be a bit protected from the conditions by being sinking in.
I don't think there's actually rain falling directly on them, so I don't think they'll get any more or less greasy than the rest. It's just the air, the humidity.
Yeah. Oh, we've got a clock back. Thank you, guys. So 4:27. Nice.
Yeah, she seems to be climbing a little bit slower, but still very quickly. I mean, she's
got plenty of time.
Two-thirds of the way up, and she's less than two-thirds of her time has gone. Much less.
Yeah, being careful with this. You don't want to drop it down low. She'll have an idea from the time she came on. Athletes are getting high up on this.
Yeah, you can tell when you're sitting behind the wall and you're sitting there for quite a long time. Like, oh, okay.
How, I always want to ask that. How? I'll ask it in a sec, actually. I'll hold that question. It's a good one, I promise. So, into the pockets again. Everyone else has reached through with the right pocket and then dropped back down.
They probably realize they're good enough to rest on and they might not get another rest before the head wall. Oh, no, not Ryu.
Yeah, Ryu comes.
She's not tired.
No, she's not at all. Immediately through. Ryu does have that endurance,
oh,
that stamina.
Drops onto the men's route.
Oh, yeah.
A tiny bit.
The crimp. So Ryu is down. It's incredible to see these athletes who are competing at the highest level on the senior circuit go to the to the youth circuit. It's almost a bit unfair, I think. It should be a rule. If you win a medal, if you get high enough up in the seniors, no more youth for you. But a lot of them are just, it's such a difficult transition from that youth circuit into the senior circuit.
For some people, definitely.
Alberto Jimenez-Lopez competed a long time in the youth as well as the senior, just to get as much experience as possible. Mm-hmm. Did you see the bat there come across the stage?
I was wondering what that was.
Yeah, there's a lot of bats around this stadium.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And I saw one fly straight across. So Natsuki Tani eyes up the jump. She uses the edging as well.
Well, she would have.
Oh, she's staticking it.
So did Ryu.
Okay, she's fully static, yeah. But she's a little bit shorter, so it's not going to be a harder static move here. Gets the heel, reaches back.
Ooh, that's not a good hold.
No, I think she might have to rethink this a bit.
Uh-oh. Yeah, she'd probably have to jump.
I can see the thinking.
This is going to be hard.
She's going to have to match it, but gets
kidding.
It in, yeah.
It wasn't hard.
But, yeah, it wasn't hard, but it yeah. I mean,
definitely burned energy going up and down.
Because maybe a jump would have been more efficient through that for her.
Yeah, I don't think she's particularly strong at jumping. It might have just been more stressful than it was worth for her.
I mean, nothing worse than holding a metal hold in my hands. That sounds as stressful to me.
Yeah. Yeah, not a huge fan of this wall with that metal thing you can grab now that we've seen, and then the slab at the top.
Yeah, it's got character, put it like that.
It's beautiful, don't get me wrong, but...
Yeah, there's a couple of odd things with it.
Yeah.
So, drop knee underneath, reaches under to get the clip. And now into those pockets. It are good. Easily three fingers in there. This press sequence, that big hold sticking out from the wall, the fin-like feature on her right. That's where she'll aim for next.
I like these holds. They're cool. Come on, that's so cute. Oh, whoa!
Oh, a big wrap.
Oh, no. Didn't like that. It's gonna jump for this one. Oh, no.
Yeah, had it. Some really unique beater going on there. Wraps it all the way around. Team Japan focused on the wall up at their athlete.
She's quite short too, so when she gets her hand wrapped over, she doesn't have so much room to wind up for the jump.
Oh, she does fall down low, head in her hands. Yeah, there are ways into it. So do go and do that if you're interested in it. It's a good part of the sport. So Lara Rogera is up, being spotted, as always, on the stage. Right, she's underway. She's going to find this route. I mean, the jump's going to be interesting for her. I know we talk about her not loving the jumps as much, but it's something she's worked really hard at getting better at.
Yeah, this year I feel like she's been committing fast and well to things.
But I think she might try to do this method.
She's seen the, yeah.
Oh, cruising that. Up with the left, locks off that shoulder.
Same beta as Natsuki, but she committed right away to it.
Natsuki wasn't really that comfortable down here, and it really shows. It's quite obvious when we see the two close together.
Yeah.
Lara looking relaxed here as she rests on the wall. That's the scoreboard. You can see Tani's score of 19 plus. And about those big volumes. We're actually seeing pretty good separation here at the moment. I was worried for a set we'd see everyone up on the head wall falling in the same place, but it hasn't quite worked out like that so far.
Yeah, Mia and Vita just climbed amazingly.
Yeah, this is the thing. When someone comes out first of all, the temptation is to go, oh, it's too easy or something. And then so often these athletes are all at a similar kind of level and it can change up and down. It's not like whoever climbs first is by far the worst climber.
No, definitely not.
So Lara's into the pockets. A little breath to herself there. It's a good crimp she's standing on. Sticks out from that metal coping. You still have to be careful on it. Resting her way through this. 4 minutes on the clock. No one getting near to times out. You start to think, remember, countback can be important, so Janja really needs to top this route if she wants the victory here this evening.
And nobody else.
And no one else, yeah.
Well, Hana and Chaeyoung can not top the route if Janja is to win.
Yeah, so there's be in the back of her mind, but they're coming up in a bit after Lara. Now, this is where Natsuki was wrapping her leg. Eyes up this shouldery move, gets it nicely. Yeah, the commitment's so much better from her on those moves.
Yeah.
Now, you are allowed to touch quick draw like that. You can't weight it, but you're allowed to move it around. Vita looking serious. So this is where there's the final pockets and then the red head wall. Coming up towards the logo on the right to finish things off. With a jump at the top, off the crimps. Lara onto the crimps, shows how small they are with that shot. She's managed to lock it off, wrapping the thumb over the top of the fingers.
She's pretty good at crimping.
Yeah, she is. I've seen some of the crimps she holds onto.
It's an understatement.
Yeah. Yeah, she loves it. And a route like this kind of suits her style, actually. These nasty crimps in between these moves. And now she'll love this next section. If she likes crimps, it's all crimps for the next couple of moves.
Yeah, she can just get a good little shake out here on these pockets. And
Lara resting as well. Below the head wall, gets vertical up there. Slightly off vertical. And now crosses through with the right.
Oh, she's bolt hanger by her feet, makes me so nervous.
That's right there, isn't it? Don't touch it, she should see it, but still.
Oh, she's good, she's chill.
She doesn't go down to the men's route. Continues up, and this is the joining point. Oh, bit of rope drag going on there.
Yeah.
Or the B layer, maybe for a second, not giving enough slack.
Or it could just be that she's pulling rope and she's so high. The rope is not straight up anymore. So where the route is gone.
Yeah, and he held her back for a sec though. Ooh, reached up to the slope, but
Yeah, that would be hard to grab that sloper in that direction.
Yeah, she's got to bring the right hand into it. Does now. The fight clear on Lara's face. Oh, just. Oh, she's still got the toes down onto the right crimp.
Oh, but a way better position than I think.
Oh, that slides off it. And out through those curtains. There she is on the stage. And she has a bit of work to do here. She's got two good climbers coming up, both of who are above her in the standings, if they all top it out with count back.
So all Janja can do now is top the route.
Yeah, exactly. And it's one of those things. I mean, she's not going to be thinking about that. All she has to do is climb and do it.
Yeah.
We get to analyze it all, but for her, her mind is going to be clearer. So straightforward down low. And Janja's very good at adapting her style to suit the conditions and what she needs to do in different parts of the route. Oh, statically reaches out. That's really stretched out.
Whoa. Oh. Okay.
Makes it work.
Yeah.
We haven't seen many jumps on this, have we? Mia and Luca both jumped.
Vita, sorry.
Both jumped. Janja's stretch, using all of her reach there to get it.
Also, remember that her finger strength is...
Would you say Janja's got the strongest fingers you've seen in the women's circuit?
Ooh. I don't know. I think so. Like, just as a climber, as a whole, she is the best.
Yeah.
For sure. The strongest, in my opinion, watching her climb.
Janja swings out towards the right now. She's using all of that finger strength on those crimps underneath the wall. Crimping underneath and then towards the pockets. Let's find out if she's feeling pockety here today. Three fingers in once again.
I'm not sure if that's a feeling I've ever had.
Feeling pockety, you should try it. It's great.
Not sure my tendons like it so much, but...
No. Yeah, it's interesting because it is different, isn't it? Being good on pockets and being having strong fingers. I mean, they're similar, but they're different skills. You need to train both of them.
Yeah. It's so much more intense when you're on a pocket with only two fingers. Obviously, you don't have those other couple fingers to help out. And
yeah, much more open as well. You can't close it off as much. So if you're good at locking off crimps, it doesn't so much help you on those open pockets. Oh, Janja with that little bump up. Ooh. Right, coming through to the right. Kicks the feet through. Good skills from her. She begins this press now.
That draw just looks so awkward.
It's always right in the face, isn't it?
It's like right on her ponytail. Yeah. But the press is really cool. I like the press a lot.
Yeah, it's a good move. And restful, as Alana was telling us earlier. Janja doesn't in any way look pumped yet. Micro shakes out as she goes forward.
Restful only for one arm, though. There's no way to match it, really. And you could. It would be just really awkward and horrible.
Yeah, so that left might be more recovered than the right. All right, up
opposite.
To the opposite, yeah. So right, up to the crimps and then pockets next. Straight into it. Really precise climbing from Janja so far. Little adjustment on that. Crosses over the top. Some have been going under. Will she drop back down like others have? She doesn't, not breathing too hard at the moment.
No. Seems. Seems very relaxed right now. Sorry.
Yeah, she does know. Total control is Janja. But there's a hard sequence to come. After the hole that everyone's dropped, says it's not easy. You still have to work your way all the way around the next big red volume. Now the crowd start to pick up a little bit as Janja nears the high point, fourth at the moment, coming towards the podium place. Crosses through. This is where these slopers get nasty. Nearly lost it with the feet. Had to kick out to the left and nails the first one. Right, it's all about this second move, though. Can she bring the left in?
Oh, and now she's...
Oh, easy. It's like a different route. A
couple more.
Out with the right, locking off that shoulder. And this is where you have to work your way over to the left. Gets awkward.
Whoa, that cross looks really awkward.
And
very
then
cool.
There is a screw on. She's dancing her feet towards it, dropping down onto it.
Nice. Oh, these crimps look so weird.
Big pebbles, isn't it? She's got a thumb involved, pressing up. Yeah, it's all about the thumbs through here. One move away from topping out this route. 1 minute 20 on the clock, blows the chalk off her fingers. Brings the feet through, sets up. And that's a top for Janja. Oh, she didn't top the semi-final route. Oh, hang on, she still hasn't finished off. Must quit the clip draw, she does. Oh, good work from Janja. Well, she's back at topping routes.
That was awesome.
So Hannah Moyle, her first lead finals, looking super chilled as well.
Oh yeah, I bet she's just so excited to climb tonight.
Yeah, she's looking really good, really relaxed this weekend. She said she was battling with the heat and struggling with it a bit, but maybe has got more used to it as the week has progressed.
Yeah, and hopefully tonight is a little bit better, because obviously this morning would have been quite hot, but now is quite a bit cooler than it was earlier.
So Hannah gets set up, springs, gets it.
Nice. And obviously we know she can jump really well. She's really good at bouldering.
Yeah, I remember in Innsbruck, she had those crazy jump sequence at the end. She's great at that. So yeah, committed to the jump, got it done, and moves fast through. Hannah hasn't topped out that many routes. In fact, I think her quali route was the first one she's topped out, and then she got another one in semis. So she's on this topping out roll.
It's a pretty good roll to be on.
Yeah, it's good. Hannah going from strength to strength this season, really made herself a contender every World Cup. Rocks up on those crimps for the feet. Hands in the pockets. And we'll rest in this stretched out position. There's a few holes, those footholds out to the left. I've only really noticed them for the first time. That one on the far left, I just wonder why that's there. That, well, there we go. Okay.
Oh, it's for this jump.
Gets
or static, yeah.
Static. Yeah, she's got that reach, hasn't she? Yeah.
Yeah, Janja also was able to static it, but I think all the others jumped.
Yeah, just a bit of a springboard there, and then this pressing move.
The coaches very nervous.
Whip, isn't it? I mean, when you spend so much time with an athlete training them to get to this level, and then you have to sit back and just let them do it. Wouldn't want that job.
It is the worst. You're way more stressed than the athlete themselves is.
You know, the athlete can do something about their own fate, can't they? As a coach, you just have to watch. Fingers crossed. So Hannah jumps up to the crimp. Drops into the first pocket. She's looking fresh at the moment. Reaches under, really flowy climbing from Hannah. Shakes out, being precise now. Now she needs to unleash her crimp strength. Matches the feet, crossing under, climbing a little bit quicker. Perhaps the pump goes.
She hasn't even been on the wall for 3 whole minutes.
Oh, so fast.
Very fast.
Hannah cruising at the moment.
Nice.
She will jump above Janja, remember, if she tops this out. Of course, she's got the tricky top crux to come. Oh. That move, every time someone does it, it looks scary. It looks like they're going to fall.
Oh,
no, and a big slip down.
Just missing out in Koper too, right?
Yeah.
Just off the podium, fourth, I think? Yeah.
Yeah, fourth, and then a silver medal in Innsbruck. So, glittering season for her. And all she needs to do is finish this route, and it will be gold. Due to count back. Long way to go, though. Needs to make the jump, first of all, clean. Save the energy through the pockets. Work out the crimps on the head wall. And then nail that awful handhold we just saw. So simple.
Yeah. Nothing, really.
Nothing to do.
We can say so confidently sitting here under our beach umbrella.
I know. Where's the cocktails? No one's bought me one yet.
She found the crimp on the side.
I never would have seen that.
No, definitely not something I would have thought to grab either.
Obviously, they've all read it and seen it together, thinking outside of the box.
Yeah.
So easily through what sometimes a jump move. I was worried these holds would all filled up with chalk and slippery, but it doesn't seem to be the case.
It's only 8 climbers, it's not that many.
No. I think in the semi-final we were really seeing a build-up on some of the holds that was causing some problems.
Is that why I fell off that?
Yeah, that must be it.
Yeah.
There was a moment that I thought you wouldn't be joining me in the commentary box. I was getting a bit nervous. So, big drop knee and a twist to get into the pockets. Rocks up, no problem so far. Halfway through this route. Reaches up again. And yeah, that foot on the far left, swap the right onto it to make the jump. Okay. He's going for the big jump, I almost said there. Cross under the quick draw, of course, hits her in the face. Clips it out of the way. And now last few to go. This is where we start to find out how much endurance she's got for the top of the route.
Yeah, looking good here, but everybody's looked pretty good here.
Yeah, they have. Hannah especially looked really fresh until she dropped that slopey hold. Yanni Garnbret watches on. She knows what this means if she tops it out. Mia Crample, 35 plus, guaranteed a medal. Brilliant from her. Hannah Moyle not safe into the medals yet. Into the crimps now. And there's a sketchy move to come where the feet skitter on that.
Yeah.
That green.
Sloper to sloper.
Yeah.
That looked every time, it looks like the person's falling.
Yeah, Hannah almost stretched it out.
Yeah, but really, like, she put her foot up there and it came off in the same half of a second. That
yeah.
was so fast.
Right, here we go. This is the sketchy move coming. She'll bring the right hand through first, then bump out towards the left. Here we go. Hold your breaths. Oh, puts the foot right in the hole.
A Brooke Rabatou.
Oh. I think we can call that a Brooke Rabatou now. She's one who made it famous. Up, just slides down onto it. And chalks up, right, she's looking solid. Right, so
that's silver guaranteed for her and gold if she tops this route.
Yeah, Hannah is pushed out of the top three. Crosses over. A lot of time left. Kicks out, oh, Yanya dropped onto it. She kicks straight into it. And now the thunder clings. Final three holds before a jump to the top. Oh, thinking about it. Oh, look at that thumb strength. Not something you say often. Oh, but she's dropping back down.
Yeah, Yanya had her entire palm on it. That looks nasty.
Really does.
Oh, my God.
Oh, look at it. And it's slopey as well.
Oh,
and then she pops. So a pop means no gold medal for her. And there are the results. Yanya Garnbret, gold medal with a top. Chenso, second. Silver for her. And Mia Crample picks up the bronze. Awesome performance from her.